hello. Felixstowe is widely regarded as being a very genteel town. It's a quiet, peaceful place by and large. It has some fine Victorian and Edwardian buildings. It has lovely views over the sea. And of course is a traditional bucket and spade resort. It's been an attractive place for folks to come and live and work for over 100 years. But you know, there are just some things, even in a town as nice as Felixstowe, that just jar your eyes. And so what I'm going to do in the next few moments is show you some of my favourite, if that's the right expression for it, some of my favourite eyesores, and I'm sure some of them will strike a chord with you too. With derelict buildings, there's always the hope that someone will come along and restore or replace them with something that looks nicer. But you can't do much about a transmission mast once it's been put up in the middle of a residential area. But I'm sure somebody regards the Ranelagh TV mast as a striking feature. That brings me to an important point. One person's eyesore is another's object of beauty. I did a little research on people's opinion of Felixstowe landmarks. Some folks find the pier an eyesore, gaudy and run down. But on the other hand, I don't think this would be a classic English seaside resort if the pier looked any different. And the owners, to their credit, have given it a much needed lick of paint this year. And then there's Manning's, same thing. Is this a tatty piece of 30s seaside architecture? Or something that people actually come from miles to see? It's a matter of opinion. But it certainly needs a coat of paint, although I must say, pink's not exactly my colour. Here's Felixstowe Docks. Is this an example of the white heat of technology with its supersized ship-to-shore cranes, container stacks, dock installations, and massive container ships? Or a massive blot on what was once a beautiful piece of shoreline? Object of modern technological art, or an industrial eyesore? Do you see the huge giraffe cranes as a symbol of modern Felixstowe, or a direction in which you prefer not to look? There's an old saying, beauty is in the eye of the beholder. So when people look at us, what do they see? Do they see something beautiful or handsome? Or are they looking at something that's unattractive, untidy, unkempt, ugly? It's all a matter of taste and personality. What does God see when he looks at the human race? Does he see something that's attractive or something else? Here's what the Bible says. There's nobody living right, not even one. Nobody knows the score. Nobody alert for God. They've all taken the wrong turn. They've all wandered down blind alleys. No one's living right. I can't find a single one. It's a depressing commentary on the human race, but true of most of our society, who don't give a mind to God at all. We all do things that we know are wrong. We think things that we know are wrong. God calls these things sin, and he finds them offensive. But what's really exciting is a God sees through all the ugliness of what we're like, the things that are wrong, whether big things or small things, and sees the beauty and worth in each of us. We've seen one or two of Felixstowe's eyesores in this video. A few are earmarked for redevelopment. Why? Because somebody saw the potential in these sites, and hopefully they're going to change into something that's really beautiful. And God loves us, and wants us to realize our potential as human beings. This is what the Bible also says. We can understand someone dying for a person worth dying for, and we can understand how someone good and noble could inspire us to selfless sacrifice. But God put his love on the line for us by offering his son in sacrificial death while we were of no use whatever to him. Jesus has put his love on the line for us so that we might be something that's beautiful to God. All we have to do is to trust him and follow him and watch him change our lives in ways that we could never imagine. Thanks for listening, and God bless you.